Marriage is for the glory of God. Jesus is passionate about it. God starts the Bible with the foundation of marriage, and he will end the Bible. He will end all of time with a marriage, the marriage supper of the Lamb of God, and all of our marriages in between. Every marriage represented here today is meant to be a picture of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Husbands loving their wives as Christ loved the church. Wives submitting to their husbands as they submit to the Lord, and what God has joined together, let no man separate. The reason that Jesus confronts their self-righteous hearts with the issue of divorce and remarriage is because it showed that they were living and operating for their own glory. They were using marriage for their own momentary glory and own momentary pleasure, when marriage is for the glory of God. And this is the very reason that Jesus came, to be the perfect groom willing to lay down his life for his bride. He willingly gave up his life to redeem our adultery toward him. He willingly forgives our cries for mercy when we have willingly chosen to defile our relationship with God. He willingly gave up his glory so he could give us the example of a love that can never be broken, never severed, never separated. And he died a death he didn't deserve so that he could bring us into a marriage that we could never earn. There are no enduring marriages without forgiveness. And you are never more like Christ than when you choose to forgive. But Jesus is this perfect example of someone who forgave us when we were far from him, when we were enemies of him. He's been faithful and just to forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. He can redeem the worst of situations, the worst of marriages, the worst of offenses, when we choose to soften our hearts and to forgive others.